Recording is on.
Today's topic is on flexible pavement using your IRC method. Okay, IRC, the code which is used for your flexible pavement design is IRC 37. Whereas for rigid pavement, it is IRC 58. I will provide this code. I have already provided the IRC 58. Okay, and now I'm providing this one also, IRC 37. No, I think I didn't provide that IRC 58. I'll give you later on. So I said there were so many methods, right? For flexible pavement design, what was the first method? The first method was your, what was the first method? What is the first method for this flexible pavement design?
Group index method.
Yes, group method. Second one was your CBR, California bearing ratio method. And this is another method, which is the modified CBR method. Okay, in the previous lecture, in CBR method, we used one formula for finding the thickness of the pavement. Okay, that was as per US Corps of Engineers formula. Whereas now this is modified CBR method. Now this method is in your IRC code, Indian Roads, R-O-A-D-S, Roads Congress. This is the code for flexible pavement design. Now before starting, we must have a clear idea, okay? What are the basic concept, or rather we can say, what are the basic parameters that are required for this flexible pavement design? As I already said, that pavement has to carry or has to cater the traffic load. Pavement is designed in such a way that it will carry a traffic load, okay? That may be in terms of axle load or standard axle load for its design period. Say for design period is for about 20 years, 15 to 20 years. For flexible pavement, the design life of the pavement will be lies between 15 to 20 years. Okay, so we have to design that pavement for 15 to 20 years so that it can carry design traffic load throughout its design life. Okay, and another important parameter is that the pavement, what is the foundation of the pavement? The foundation is the subgrade over which we have to lay the pavement layers. Okay, we have to lay the pavement layers. The foundation is the subgrade. So we must have a clear idea about the property of the soil that we are using for this subgrade, in this subgrade layer. Okay, so previously it was what? We can use CBR method. We can also use group index method to classify this soil property. And here also we have that parameter, okay, which is the CBR, California bearing ratio, which will define the strength, or rather we can say the bearing capacity of the subgrade soil, compacted soil, which is used in subgrade. See, if this subgrade is of good quality, that means it will carry huge amount of load, so the thickness may be lesser. Okay, if this is a weak quality of aggregates or weak quality of fine aggregates, then it may not carry or it may not bear that amount of the load. So we have to increase the thickness so that we can increase this area. Ultimately, we have to increase this surface contact area, okay, where the load is being distributed to the soil. We have to increase this. So in order to increase it, we have to increase the height of the pavement. So these are the two important factors. First is design traffic, and this is your CBR. From the previous lecture, we already know how we can conduct this test, how we can estimate the CBR value of a given subgrade sample. Okay, so this one we can easily calculate from the experiment basis. Okay, so the new term which is in this method is this design life. This will be the new term for you. Okay, so we have to determine this one, and which is denoted by capital N. So if we know this capital N value and if we know this CBR value, then using different charts, there will be different charts, okay, like this charts. in your IRC code using the value of N and CBR, we can calculate the thickness. What will be the thickness of the pavement, total thickness, using such charts. I will show you in later on, okay? So first we have to find the CBR. It will be provided in your question, or they may ask you to calculate the value. And the second one is, the most important one is to calculate the N, okay? This is the, what is now N? N is the cumulative repetition of, you can note it down. N is the cumulative repetition of standard axle load. Okay. This is the cumulative repetition of the standard axle load that a pavement can carry throughout its design life. Okay. As per the definition, what is this? N is the cumulative. That means this is, suppose this is the pavement, its design life is say for 15 years. Okay. We have to design this for 15 years. So the wheel load, or the standard axle load, we can rather say standard axle load. The load will come repetitively, right? Only one vehicle will not move from this pavement. There will be several categories of vehicle, several types of vehicle, and similar type of vehicle will also move for several time. So it is repetitive, and we have to cumulative it. That means we have to keep on adding. Okay, suppose today only 10 vehicles moved over this pavement. Next day another 20 vehicles move. So total cumulative is how much? 10 plus 20, 30. Okay, next day and again 10 vehicle move. So total cumulative 3 days will be 10 plus 20 plus 10, 40. So like this cumulative, we have to take some for 15 years. So till throughout its design year or design life, how many such vehicle will pass from this pavement cumulatively? We have to calculate that vehicle, and it is denoted by capital N in the IRC 37 code. Okay,
which is
that means, see, if in order to I'm saying that, what is this capital N? Capital N means that suppose this pavement is the layer pavement, this is the pavement layer. Okay, we are seeing this in transverse view. This is longitudinal view. We are side view. We can rather say side view. We cut the pavement and we are seeing from the side. Okay, these are the different layers, and this is the total thickness of the pavement. I'm saying that in order to design this thickness, we must know how many vehicles or any standard axle load will move from this pavement throughout its design life. Okay. And we have to take it as a cumulative. Cumulative means, suppose today 10 vehicles, 10 axle load went over this pavement. Okay. So for today, the cumulative number will be 10. Next day, another 10 vehicles move. So for next day, total cumulative will be how much? 10 plus 10, 20. And for third day, suppose 30 vehicles moved. So total will be how much? 10 plus 10 plus. For 3 days, it will be, first day it was 10, second day it was 10. So, and the third day it is 30. So total cumulative number of vehicles is 10 plus 10 plus 30. That means 50. So till third day, 30 vehicles moved from this, sorry, 50 vehicles moved over this pavement structure. So how many vehicles will move over this structure? This is known as N. Okay. And here we will assume it as the number of repetition of standard axle load. Everything should be standardized. Okay. Now, in order to determine this N, it's not an easy method. We can't measure for 15 years, continuous 15 years. We can't keep on taking the readings, right? So there is a formula derived in IRC 37, which is shown like this. See, this is the formula. Everybody can see this one. See, yes, it's ma'am. it's in page 14.
That is zoom karun.
See this formula. Okay, it's in IRC 37. I have already provided this one in the Google Classroom. You can go through it.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is that formula N. See, it's given the cumulative number under axle load to be scattered. Scatter means to be that will move, that will be carried by the pavement for its design life. Okay. See here, there are so many factors. What is this? This is R factor is there. One small R is there. Wait, I will zoom it. See here, one R value is there, small n is there, okay? This is multiplication, okay? X, not X, this is multiplication. A is there, D is there, F is there, okay? What are these? So in order to calculate this value, we must know all these values. I'll be explaining these values only, okay? What are these values, one by one? So let us go to our note. See, what are the different factors on which this capital N, or we can say design traffic, on which the factors affecting design traffic or capital N are? First is what? Standard axle load. We must consider every load as a standard axle load. I mean, we have to change the load into standard axle load. Okay. Second one is initial traffic. Please listen clearly. This is initial traffic after construction. Okay. Initial traffic after construction. That means what? Suppose today you have started the construction of the project. Okay. Will it take one day to complete the project? I mean, say construction of the pavement. Will it take one day? Today you started and today only it will be completed. No. It may take 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, like, to complete the project. Okay, so the year 2020, you started to construct the project. Okay, at that time, there will be one traffic. That means traffic volume. That is the number of vehicles moving per hour. There will be some amount. Suppose that amount is your P value. Okay, what did I say? 2020. In 2020, the traffic count, the number of the vehicles, your volume of the vehicles, volume of the traffic is P. And the construction period is suppose X. That means for X period, or here I will give you one example. Suppose 2020, your traffic is what? I said it is P. Now the construction took place for about, suppose, 3 years. So that X is equals to 3 years. Okay. So can we say that after 3 years, this traffic value will remain same? Suppose 2023. That means after construction, you are now allowing the vehicle to pass over the highway. You constructed a highway, flexible pavement highway. Okay. For 3 years, it was construction period. And after 3 years, that is 2023, you are allowing the vehicle to move over that highway. Okay, they can now use the highway. So can we say that this P and the traffic at 2023 will be same? Suppose 2023, it is A, when the traffic was in operation. Okay, this was the before construction and this is after construction of the pavement. So, will it be same?
No, ma'am.
No, which one will be greater? Hmm?
2023.
Obviously, 2023 will be greater, right? Because
yes, ma'am.
Traffic will increase by certain rate. Per year, it will increase by certain rate. Suppose that rate is given by small r. Okay? That growth rate, traffic growth rate per annum is given by small r. If in the question it is not given, then assume it as 7.5%. You can note it down also. That means if traffic growth rate is not provided, then we can assume as per IRC that it is assumed to be 7.51%. So initially it was P before construction, now it is A. Okay, and the construction period was how much? 3 years. So there is a relationship, future value and present value and future value relation. You already know like that only. This is your present value. This is a future value. Future for how many years? 3 years. So A is equals to P 1 plus R to the power X. Okay. So this is the relation. A and P relation is this one. A is equals to P 1 plus R to the power X, where X is the construction period, P is before construction traffic, and A is after construction traffic, where R is the traffic growth rate, at how much rate the traffic is increasing per year. Understood, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what about ma'am. Others? Okay. Now, this is that one value, okay? So, on this present, on this one, now A is what? It is the traffic when the road was in operation. That means now we can operate the roadway. That means we can use the roadway. Okay, this is the A. So on this value also, our cumulative load, it depends. Okay, so this is we have to use this also in our formula for getting N. Now it is defined as what is the unit of this A on P? P and A, they have same unit. What is this? CVPD, commercial vehicle per day. As I already said in my previous lecture, that we have to, for design purpose, we can't consider any vehicle as our standard vehicles. Okay? For design purpose, we are considering only the commercial vehicles. Now, what are those commercial vehicles? Vehicles are said to be commercial when their laden weight means gross weight, means when it is fully loaded along with its own weight. Okay, if that weight is greater than how much ton? I said it was 3 tons. Okay, if the laden weight of a vehicle is greater than 3 ton, then that vehicle is considered as commercial vehicle. Okay, so we are considering, for design purpose, we have to consider loads or the axle load only for commercial vehicle. That's why the traffic is how much? It is denoted by commercial vehicle per day. Okay. Now comes traffic growth rate. As I already said, it is denoted by small r. Design life in number of years, it is denoted by small n in that formula. Okay, this was the formula. Suppose here it was the formula. So this R is the traffic growth rate. This R is your traffic growth rate. Okay. And this N, small n, you can see here. See, this is the small n. This N is your design life. I said we have to find out the number of repetition for its design period. And design period is about 15 to 20 years. So what will be the increase in the traffic during its design life? So that's why here N is here. Okay. Now,
ma'am, bolchi je inta jodi e hoy tale design life, inta ki bole small inta,
it is the design life of the pavement. Okay. I said there is one X, okay, that was your period of construction of the pavement. Okay, it may be 2 to 3 or 4 years. Okay, whereas N is the after construction, now you are allowing the vehicles to move on. Okay, so it has to, what to say, it has to be in good condition towards its life. That design life is your N, denoted by small n, and it is 15 to 20 years for flexible pavement. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now another factor, two important factors are there. See here, you can see two more factors are there. Now you know what is R, what is N, what is A. All is a traffic. This is traffic after construction. This is your traffic growth rate per annum. If it is not given, assume it as 7.5. N is the number of years, I mean design life. Now comes D, and F. What are these values? See, F is your vehicle damage factor. Okay. And D is your lane distribution factor, LDF, lane distribution factor. Okay. And this is VDF, vehicle damage factor. Now, before going into details, explain this one. See, I said standard axle load is important. See, the first factor is standard axle load. Now, what is standard axle load? For single axle, I already said that it should be 8160 kg or 8.16 or 8.2 tons or 80 kilonewton. Okay. This you have already known. Now, for tandem axle, it is 14.968 kg or 14.96 ton or 149 kilonewton. Okay. Now, as I said that we for design purpose, we have to consider only for the rear axle. Rear axle means the back axle, which is in the back side. This is the front portion. This is the back portion. See, this is the single axle. Yeah, only one axle is there. So this is single axle and its standard axle load is here 816 kg, 60. Axle, this one, okay? This one, not the wheel. There is wheel load and this is axle load. Don't get confused. Now see here, in this case, it has two axles. So tandem axle. And for this, the total standard axle load is 14.96 tons or 14.968 kg. Okay. This one we have to take into consideration. It may not provide in all questions. That time we have to assume it. Okay. The another term was what? The second term was initial traffic construction. Initial traffic after construction in terms of CBPD. See here. As I already said, this is the formula. P into 1 plus R to the power X. P is the last traffic count before construction of pavement in CBPD. And this is the after construction. Okay, when the road is open for operation. R is your annual traffic. If not given, assume this much. X is the duration of construction period. Okay, this one we have to assume if it is not provided. Clear? Till now, any doubt? Or in them, nay? Kono doubt ache?
No, ma'am. No doubt. No doubt, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Acha. See, the third topic was what? The third topic was your traffic growth rate. This I've already explained. It's given here. See, 7.5. And the fourth one is your design life of flexible pavement in number of years, denoted by small n. For national highway and state highway, if not provided, assume it as 15 years. Okay. Expressways or urban roads. Urban roads means the road which are in your metropolitan cities like Delhi, Kolkata, where there will be heavy traffic. Okay, there will be heavy traffic volume. There it should be designed for more years. It should last for more years. So we have to design in such a way. So 20 years. Okay. And other categories of road. This means less important road. It is assumed to be 10 years to 15 years. Okay. Now, see, I was talking about this one. VDF, vehicle damage factor. So can anyone tell me what is this vehicle damage factor? Any idea?
Ma'am, vehicle accident onujayi hoy eta.
Vehicle
accident onujayi hoy eta vehicle damage.
No, that's the confusion. Okay, that's the main confusion between that you are telling. That is another. That is VOC, vehicle operating cost. Okay, that is due to pavement. If there will be damage in the vehicle. As you said, accident, okay, if the surface is not proper, smooth, not providing enough skid, then there may be accident. There may be accidents, okay? So due to accident, there will be some loss to the vehicle, that is your vehicle operating cost. Now this one is what? Due to vehicle, what are the damages that is caused in the pavement? That is your vehicle damage factor. Clear? Due to vehicle. Vehicle means your axle load only. Due to axle load, what is the damage that is caused in the pavement? Whether it may be deformation, whether it may be cracks, anything. Anything, okay?
Madam, so, axle load ta ekbar bolben?
Axle load?
Yes, ma'am.
See, this is the axle load. This is your vehicle, top view, okay? This is the front bumper, this is a rear bumper. For design purpose, we must consider this axle. Axle means this one. Okay. You can go through my previous lecture also. I have shown it in 3D diagram.
Okay, this one
is a front axle. This is your rear axle. Rear means back portion. Front means front, okay. And these are the wheels. Okay.
So for
design purpose, we have to consider the rear axle only. Why? Because maximum load is transferred to the pavement from the back axle only, not from the front.
Okay. Thank you.
So, and these are the values. These are the standard values. Okay. It should be standard axle load. We should like, it should be this much amount. But in certain case, what happens that vehicles may carry more loads than this standard axle load. Okay. They will transmit more load. They will transmit more load to the pavement, more than this standard axle load. But we have to limit that value. And that value is known as legal axle load. Okay. One is standard axle load, another is legal axle load. So we can say that legal axle load will be smaller than standard axle load. Suppose standard axle load is, I said, 8.2 tons, okay, for single axle. This is your single axle. For this single axle, standard axle load is 8.2 tons. But its legal axle load will be more than 8.2 tons. That will be, suppose, 10 tons. This is, we can allow the vehicle which has the standard axle load of 8.2 up to 10 ton only. Legally, we can allow that vehicle. We can't allow that vehicle to carry load more than 10 tons. Okay. So these are the legal axle load, and it is always greater than standard axle load. Now, VDF. Okay. VDF is what? I said, suppose this is the pavement, okay. Suppose standard axle vehicle, one vehicle, commercial vehicle, or which is standard vehicle, okay. It will carry standard axle. That is 8.12 ton it will carry. Now, if it moves, it will cause some damage. Suppose in forms of deformation. Suppose this is that damage caused by the standard axle load, okay. And on the same pavement, there is another load, another vehicle, which may be less than standard axle or which may be greater than standard axle. So it will also cause some deformation. Okay. Suppose this is ith vehicle, any ith vehicle. Okay. Now, can we say that deformation is directly proportional to its weight, to the weight of vehicle or to the weight of axle load? If it is more axle load, that means more deformation. If it is less axle load, deformation or damage will be less. Can we say?
Yes, ma'am.
So we can say that deformation or damage caused by the axle load is directly proportional to its weight. Okay. So deformation, suppose caused by this vehicle, we can considered it as WI. That means, since it is directly proportional to the weight, we can say that damage caused by this ith vehicle is WI and the standard axle vehicle is WS. Okay.
Deformation ta kotha hobe, ma'am?
Below this one, I'm taking one example only. Okay. It may be deformation, it may be cracks, it may be rutting. There are so many failures. Okay, I will explain you in the later class. There are so many failures that will be developed due to loading condition.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. I'm just giving one example. Suppose deformation is one kind of your damage. Deformation, it will be in the pavement. Suppose this is your pavement. The pavement layer will be deformed due to load. You know that flexible pavement will deform due to load. Yeah. So, suppose that deformation is directly proportional to the weight, as I said. So, we can say that damage equals to WS and damage caused by ith vehicle equals to WI. Okay. So, if we divide these two, that means we are finding the damage caused by ith vehicle relative to the damage caused by the standard axle vehicle. Clear? Damage caused by the ith vehicle relative to the damage caused by the standard axle vehicle is your vehicle damage factor. Okay. So, suppose this is this one. So, we can say that vehicle damage factor is directly proportional to WI by WS. Okay. Now, as per ASTHO, they have given one formula. What did I say? Vehicle damage factor is proportional to the ratio of WI, that is damage caused by the ith vehicle, and WS, that is the damage caused by the standard axle vehicle. Okay. So, see here, as per ASTHO, fourth power damage formula has been used to derive this PDF. And this is this equation. Okay, mute kore dao ektu. See, fourth power law, why? Because we are giving it fourth power to this damage ratio. Okay, car, mute koro ne ektu. Eko hoche. Okay. Now, if we multiply this one with the corresponding number of vehicles. See, these V1, V2, V3 are the number of the vehicles. That means what? See, here it can, you can see here. Now, what is this? W1, W2, W3 are the, note it down. This is your mean value. Mean value of axle load groups. In some problem, they won't give the one value for the axle load. They will give you some range. Say, for example, 17 turn to 14, sorry, 15 turn, like this. Okay. They will say that this axle load range, axle load ranging from 17 turn to 15 turn, this type of vehicles came for 4 times. That means this range of vehicles came over the pavement for 4 times. Okay. So, what will be the mean value of this one? 16. Right? So, this 16 is your W1, W2. Suppose this is your W1 for first range. Another range will be your, suppose, 15 to 13. Then what will be the mean value? 14. So, W2 will be your 14. And for this range, they say that suppose this axle load ranging from this one to this time came to the pavement for about 10 times. This is the number of the vehicles, okay? 4 number of vehicles having this range, within this range, okay? And this is 10 number of vehicle lying within this range. So, V1 is 4. W1 will be 16 and WS will be your standard axle load. If it is given for single axle, then WS will be, if it is in turn, then it will be 8.2 turns. If the load range is in between kg, given in kg, then WS will be in kg. That is 8160 kg. Okay. And divided by the total number of the vehicles. V1, V2 are what? Respective traffic volume. For this axle load range, what are the respective traffic volume? These are given by V1, V2, whereas WS is the standard axle load. I will show you one example. Sorry, it is also given by this formula also, okay, VDF. in terms of frequency, sometimes they will not give you V1, V2 value. That means they will not give you number, in number, in terms of number. They will give you in percentage. Okay? That time we have to use this formula. Now, F1 is what? Frequency of W1 axle load. F2 is frequency of W2 axle load. F3 is frequency of W3 axle load. Now, what is frequency? Can anyone tell? Here, what do you mean by the frequency? If I said, say for example here, see here, it's like this: from axle load survey, following data has been found for single axle load. Okay, it's already told that this is single axle. So here we know, we can conclude that WS will be how much? See here, the axle load range is given in ton. So WS will be in, what will be the value of WS then? Axle load range is in, unit is in ton. That means 17 ton to 15 ton it is given. What will be the WS value? WS is the standard axle load.
Ma'am, follow 8160 jeta ache jeta ki tone.
Exactly. So WS will be your, it's in ton, so convert it into ton, we can say 8.6 or 8.2 ton. Okay. So here WS will be 8.2. Okay, now see, here it's given percentage frequency. They are not giving you the, they are not giving you the number, they are giving you the percentage frequency. It's in, suppose this range of vehicles are coming for 4%. That means if you are taking a sample of 100 vehicles, so out of 100, 4 vehicles will be within this range. Okay, if you are taking 100 sample, then 19 vehicles will be in this range. Similarly, 24 vehicles will be in this range. Okay, so these are your F1, F2, F3, F4, like that. So we can conclude, since it is percentage, convert into decimal. So 4% is 0.04, 19 is 0.19, like that. And I said that here in the formula, there will be WII, W1 or W2. All these are the mean value. That means, what is the value of this one? 17 plus 15 by 2, this is nothing but the 16. What is the mean value of this second one? 15 plus 13 by 2 will give you 14. So these are W1, W2 like that. And these are corresponding F1, F2 like that. Okay. Sometimes if they are not giving you this in the percentage, they will give you a number. That time we have to use the above formula. See, if it is in number, then we have to use number here also, and we have to divide it by the total summation of the numbers also. Okay. And if it is frequency, we will just write here that 0.04 into 17 plus 15 by 2, it was 16. Okay, like that. See here. See, F1 W1 by WS to the power 4. As I said, it is single axle, so it will be 8.2. So 0.2. F1 is the frequency of the first axle range road, that is 0.04, and W1 is 16. Similarly, write down F2 is your 0.19, mean value is 15 plus 13 by 2, 14, and by WS is your 8.2. So after calculating, we are getting 4.23. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. ম্যাম বলছি উপরের ফর্মুলাটা একবার দেখাবেন, আমি একটু লিখে নেব।
ঠিক আছে, আমি নোটসটা দিয়ে দেবো। ঠিক আছে,
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে তাহলে ম্যাম।
এই যে দেখো, ওকে, সি দিস আর দা নাম্বার, নট দা পার্সেন্টেজ। দ্যাটস ওয়াই উই আর রাইটিং দা, দিস ইজ নাথিং বাট, নাও ইফ উই অ্যাড আপ অল দিস, ইউ উইল গেট দা টোটাল ভলিউম অফ ট্রাফিক, and if we divide by total, we will ultimately get the frequency only. Okay, this is the suppose total is your 100 sample. I said this is four vehicles will come out of total. Yeah, point four vehicles will come out of 100. So what is the frequency? 4 divided by 100 is 0.04 only. Similarly, if we divide this one by this one, this is suppose it is 9 vehicles will come for this range and the total is 100. So 9 divided by 100 will give you 0.09. So ultimately, this is in number, in terms of number, and this is in terms of frequency. Now, see, it depends on several factors, VDF. I said again, it depends. I said it depends on the axle range. That means it depends on the axle loading. And again, axle loading depends on the axle configuration, whether it is one single axle, double axle, or tandem axle, or tridem axle, like that. Also depends on the terrain is nothing but the longitudinal slope of a particular area. Okay, terrain. Whether it is hilly area, whether it is plain area, like that. Also depends on the types of road, WBM, okay, bituminous macadam, what kind of road. And also varies from region to region. In heavy rainfall area, what will happen? The subgrade will be, it will contain more moisture content, so it will be loose in strength. So obviously due to loading, it will deform more. Okay, so vehicle damage factor will be more. And this is a table for that where it is showing that this one vehicle damage factor depends on the terrain. It's already in the code also. Now the last important factor is D. Okay, VDF was F, capital F, and this is the D. Now lane distribution means, say for example, this is a single lane road. Okay. There are two type of carriageway. Carriageway means what? The area which is purposely made for the vehicles only. Okay. Outside that area, vehicles can't move. Okay. Suppose that area is this one. And that is known as carriageway. Okay. Here it is footpath. Here also it is footpath. So the carriageway for this vehicle is this one only. Here to here. Okay, this is the single carriageway. Now, sometimes in national highway, you can see that there will be two carriageway. Two carriageway means one median will be there in between the two carriageway. Suppose this is carriageway for this direction traffic and this is carriageway for this direction traffic. So, this is your two carriageway, yeah, dual carriageway with median at its between, in between. Okay, so this is a difference between single carriageway and dual carriageway. Okay, now comes what is lane distribution. Say in this case, this is also single carriageway. See, here is only one carriageway, here also only one carriageway. But here it is one lane and here it is two lane. Okay, see 3.5 meter, 3.5 meter, and here is only one lane, single lane. So can you tell me where you have the opportunity to overtake? In which condition? You have more possibility that you can overtake and move, cross that slow moving vehicle. Suppose this is a slow moving vehicle and you are here at the back side. Okay. This is moving with a slow speed, but you have to go fast. So, but you, because of the lack of the space, you can't overtake that slow moving vehicles. But if this vehicle pass from here, then only you will get the path and you will have to follow that vehicle. Okay, that means this vehicle will also use this lane, you will also use this lane. So the lane is what to say, traffic is fully distributed over this single lane. Clear? This slow moving vehicles also has to cover this area. And this also has to cover this area and move forward. It has no chance to cross, overtake and come here. So this lane, this width is totally utilized by all the vehicles that will pass from this carriageway. So we can say that lane distribution factor is 100%, which is considered as 1. So for single lane, whether it will be dual carriageway or it will be single carriageway, LD, lane distribution factor, or D will be 100%, which is 1. Why? Because all the traffic has to use this lane only. They have no chance or no opportunity to use another lane. Okay. Similarly, here, see here. Suppose this is that slow moving vehicle, this one. Now you are moving towards the two lane carriageway. This is a slow moving vehicle. You are following it. What you are doing then? Now you have that possibility, or you have that chance, opportunity to cross, overtake this vehicle. Okay. See here, overtake this vehicle. Okay. So you are not using now this portion of lane. This lane, this area is not used by you, your vehicle. You are using that portion where you're using it here. Lane you are using. Okay. So can we say that it is fully utilized? This lane, only this lane is fully utilized? No. It is utilized by only few vehicles. Not all vehicles will fully utilize the this lane. Okay. So only few vehicles will cover this area and move forward. But some vehicles, because of the opportunity, they will have the tendency to overtake, change the lane, use this portion of lane, and again come back to its original lane. So this lane is not utilized by all the vehicles. So they have decided that, as per the IRC, they are saying that only 75% of the vehicle will use this lane fully. Okay, another 25, they have the tendency to change the lane and use another portion of the lane. So here it is 0.75. So lane distribution is reduced. So can we say if there will be more number of lanes, then there will be more number of opportunities for the vehicles to not use this lane if slow moving vehicle is there. So LDF will automatically reduced. And depending on it, these are the values. See here. For single lane, D is 100%, so 1. For two lane, it is reduced to 75%, 0.75. For three lane, again reduced to 60%, 0.6. And for four lane, it is 0.4. This is for single carriageway road. Okay, that means, see, if we add both the direction traffic, suppose if we add both the direction traffic, we are getting 100 vehicles. So we can say that out of 100 vehicles, only in single lane, all 100 vehicles will pass from this lane. That's why it is 1. Whereas in two lane, only 75 vehicles will pass from this lane and 25 will use another lane. So that's why lane distribution for this lane is 0.75, 75%. Okay. Similarly, for dual carriageway, these are the values. Okay, you can get it from the IRC code also. See, for two lane, same. Two dual carriageway, two lane. See, this is dual carriageway, two lane, 75. Here also it was 75. For two lane, single carriageway, here also it is 75. Okay, for three lane, it is 60. Here also it is 60. But for four lane, it is little different. For dual carriageway, it has 45%, 0.45, and for single, it is 0.4. You have to keep it in mind. If no other data is provided, if only single carriageway, two lane, by single carriageway, four lane, then we have to assume this data. In some problem, they will give you the direct value, or if they will give you this value. If they won't give you this value, then they will give you the condition. Single carriageway, two lane, three lane, like that. Yeah, dual carriageway, two lane, three lane, like that. That time we have to then assume the values as per the IRC 37. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Doubt ache?
No, ma'am, no doubt, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Sure.
No, ma'am.
Acha. Now see, I said all the factors I have explained one by one. Okay. First was your A. Okay. মানে ট্রাফিক আফটার কনস্ট্রাকশন, এ আফটার কনস্ট্রাকশন, ওকে ইউ ক্যান রিমেম্বার লাইক দ্যাট অলসো। আর ইজ ট্রাফিক গ্রোথ রেট, এন ইজ ডিজাইন লাইফ ইন নাম্বার অফ ইয়ার্স, ইট অলসো ডিপেন্ডস অন দ্য টাইপ অফ দ্য হাইওয়েজ, ওয়েদার ইট ইজ হাইওয়ে, ওয়েদার ইট ইজ লেস ইম্পর্টেন্ট রোড, ওয়েদার ইট ইজ আরবান রোড, দ্যাট টাইম অলসো উই হ্যাভ টু অ্যাজিউম। ডি ইজ ল্যান্ড ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন ফ্যাক্টর, এফ ইজ ইয়োর vehicle damage factor, and there is one more term which is not in the equation here but I have added here, LSF, that is load safety factor, okay, and it is considered to be assumed to be one if no data is provided. Sometimes they will give you this LSF also, say for example 1.3, that time we have to add it, multiply it, otherwise no need to multiply, leave it as simple one, okay. See, after calculation, putting all the values from the given problem, we will get a huge number.
Ma'am, kono bujha jacche na.
Ha? Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am, shunte pacchi.
Bakira? Shunte pachho, Bakira?
Shone ache, shone ache.
এবার দেখতে পাচ্ছ প্রিথা?
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম দেখা যাচ্ছে,
দেখা যাচ্ছে ম্যাম।
ওরই তাহলে নেটওয়ার্কে প্রবলেম হতে হবে। আচ্ছা শোনো,
আমি এবার দেখা যাচ্ছে।
আচ্ছা দেখা যাচ্ছে, ঠিক আছে। সি হিয়ার, দ্যার ইজ ওয়ান মোর টার্ম, আই হ্যাভ অ্যাডেড ওয়ান মোর টার্ম, LSF, দ্যাট ইজ লোড সেফটি ফ্যাক্টরস, ওকে। ইফ দে উইল নট গিভ ইউ এনিথিং, দেন অ্যাজুম ইট অ্যাজ ওয়ান, আদারওয়াইজ দে ইন সাম প্রবলেম দে উইল গিভ ইউ সাম ভ্যালুজ অলসো, দ্যাট টাইম ইউ হ্যাভ টু মাল্টিপ্লাই ইট, আদারওয়াইজ ইট ইজ কেপ্ট অ্যাজ ওয়ান, ওকে। নাও সি, all the values and calculating, we will get a huge number. Why? Because we are designing, we are calculating the repetition, that also cumulative, okay, not only the number of loads, we are cumulative, we are taking out the cumulative value, at least we are keep on adding those number of repetition till its design life, okay. And for design life means it is for more than 15 years, 15 to 20 years, so obviously we will get that how many vehicles, yeah, how many axle load has passed over that vehicle during its will pass over the
ma'am abar ki dekhao jacche na shonao jacche na thik thak kore
tomar problem hocche net er go baki rate dekhte pacche bolche ebar dekhte pachho
ha ma'am dekha jacche shonao jacche dekha jacche
so we'll get a huge number, okay. Now that number
ma'am shonao jacche na dekhao jacche na
bolchi
tumi abar add koro na, abar leave kore abar add koro to, main join koro to, baki de to shona jacche bolche ekhane to problem
shona jacche,
tumi abar ekbar leave kore add on kor, join koro, ebar dekho if we will multiply this and whatever value that will get, that is your cumulative standard axles, CSA, okay, this will be a huge value. But for design value we need MSA, that means we have to convert this CSA to MSA. Now MSA is what? As I said, CSA is cumulative standard axle, whereas MSA is million standard axle, million, okay. That means MSA will be times of CSA, so that's why we are multiplying this with, see, 10 to the power minus 6. We are converting the CSA. If we use only this bordered formula, then we will get CSA. But for design, we need this MSA, that is million standard axle. So we have to, whatever value we will get from here, we have to multiply with it 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay. So for design purpose, if they ask traffic is measured in, it should be MSA, million standard axle. Now, now what? As I said, we need two values. We need what? We need N and we need what? CBR. So after calculation, this will be given. Okay. And this one we calculated. Now what? After that, ultimately our motive is calculate the thickness of the pavement. To calculate the thickness of the pavement. Pavement means what? Above the subgrade layer, whatever layers comes, that thickness is the pavement. So we have to design this thickness. Okay. Now for this, we have to use these two values and some charts. See, after calculating the number of repetition of standard axle, which is N, and CBR of subgrade, we have to design the total thickness of the pavement as well as individual layer thickness. Pavement consists of several layers. We have to find out first, we have to find out the total as well as the individual layers. Okay, as per the IRC 37. Now see here, there is one chart, which is the pavement thickness design chart. It's given in page 8 and 9. Suppose here I will show you IRC 37, page 8 and 9. See this one. This is the chart. Okay. Suppose, see here. This is the chart. So this is, see, design traffic in MSA. That means this is what? This is your, this axis. X axis is your N value in MSA. Okay. And individual, this curves, it is your CBR values. See here, CBR value, CBR 2, CBR 3, 4, like that they are given. So individual curve is your CBR value. Okay. Now, after calculating N value, and also we know the CBR value, can we get the total thickness, which is given by this axis, Y axis? How we will get? Say for example, N came out to be your 8 MSA. Okay. 8 MSA was the N value. And the CBR given is your, suppose, 4, means this curve. Okay. So carry this line to upward perpendicular and see where it touches. The CBR equals to 4 curve. It touches here. Now find the corresponding y-axis value. So can we see how much for 8 NSA and CBR equals to 4, the corresponding total thickness is about 680. What is 680 millimeter? Okay, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The problem, they will give you only this chart. Okay, they will directly give you this chart in your problem. So like this, you have to find out the total thickness. Okay, and this one you have to see that this one is between your 1 to 10 MSA. When the traffic lies between 1 to 10 MSA only. If traffic is greater than 10 MSA, then we have to use this chart. See here, it's 10 to 150 MSA. Okay. And sometimes, as I said, this from this chart, we will get only the total thickness. Then what about the individual layer thickness? For that, go to page 21 to 37. That is pavement design catalog. There will be many catalogs from where we can find the individual thickness. Okay. See, this was your total thickness chart, design chart for 10 and 150 MSA. And that catalog will look like this from the page. Okay. Catalog will look like this. Suppose I said it is in page 21, right? See here. It starts from here. See this one first, catalog, second, third. Okay. Fourth, fifth, like this. So which catalog we have to use? For that, again, we must see the first table, first one. Recommendation design for traffic recommended designs for traffic range 1 to 10 MSA. Our I said n value was 8 MSA. Okay, so it will lie between this one. Okay, now go to this one. See the CBR value. What did I say? Our CBR value is 4%. So we can't use this table. Okay, we can use this catalog. So move to another catalog. See here, it is again 1. I say okay, but here CBR is 3. So we can't use this also. Now see here, it is 1 to 10 MSA and CBR is 4. Okay, so we can use now this catalog. Okay, and see here, how we will have to calculate here. See, it's given total cumulative traffic. It's not in a regular basis. There are some gaps. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's not there. 5 is there. Then direct 10 value is there. Okay. But our value came out to be, what did I say? In our example, I said n came out to be 8. See, for example, if your value came out to be 10 MSA and CBR is 4, then what is the total thickness? 700 thickness. Millimeter thickness. Okay, and I said that pavement consists of how many layers? First is your bituminous surface, which consists of two layers, that is wearing course, binder. Then below that there will be some base course, granular base, and below that there will be granular sub base, and below that there will be subgrade. Please remember that pavement means only the layers between top and the subgrade. Okay, this is the subgrade layer. Then pavement consists of only how many layers? 1, 2, 3, 4. That means wearing course, binder course, base course and sub base. So this is the total pavement thickness. Okay, not the sub, including subgrade. We can't include subgrade in the pavement. Subgrade is acting as a foundation, but the pavement means that above subgrade, whatever layers comes, that is your pavement thickness. So see here, first thickness is your wearing course. For 10 MSA, it will be 40 mm. For 10 MSA, binder course will be 80. Then again, for 10 MSA, it will be 250, 360. Here you can see here, this is the structure of the pavement. Okay, this is your first wearing course, binder course. Okay, this is a granular base, this is a granular sub base, and below is the subgrade. This is the top surface. Okay, now I said that our value is not 10 nor 5, not 3 nor 2, like that. Our value is 8, so it lies somewhere between 5 to 10. So what we have to do, we have to just interpolate these values, these two values. Okay, you have to interpolate all the values between 5 and 10. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Let us see one example. It will be clear then. See here. Is given, design the pavement for construction of a national highway. Okay, with the following data. What is this? Two lane single carriageway. For national highway, what will be the n value? I said it will be 15 years. Okay, 15 years. Two lane single carriageway means what factor we will get from this data? D value. For two lane single carriageway, it was only 75% will use that single lane, so it will be 0.75. okay, traffic count as per last count, traffic volume as per last count. This one is last count or before construction. After construction is A, so this is before construction, so this is your P. Okay, now types of road, it's already given national highway. VDF, this is your F. Okay, and CBR is given. So they're asking you to design the pavement. That means design the thickness of the pavement. Clear? So can we solve this problem? First, we have to find capital N. CBR is given, okay, in terms of MSA. N in terms of MSA. Okay. So can we calculate? Please use this formula. This formula. If we use this formula, we will get cumulative standard XL. Multiply this value with 10 to the power minus 6, we will get million standard XL. So please calculate the N value for this problem. And other data are need to be assumed. Other data means your traffic growth rate is not given. So we can assume it as 7.5%. Okay. Construction period is also not given. So we can assume it as 3 years. That I will give you. Assume construction period as that is X equals to 3 years. Okay. We have to use this formula. First, this formula, find A. Suppose you got this one. P is your 322 CVPD. R is your, I said traffic growth rate is 7.5%. That means 0.075. Okay. It's your period of construction. So X, assume it as 3 years. So after assuming all the data and putting the value, we will get capital A, which is 400 CVPD. Now use the above formula. কত আসবে একটু ক্যালকুলেট করে বলো আমাকে ক্লিয়ার তো ওর ফর্মুলা নিচে দিয়েছি দেখো ক্যালকুলেট করছো আচ্ছা সাগনিকপুর কাজ তো আছো
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম আছি ম্যাম
আচ্ছা বুঝতে পারছো তো
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম
ক্যালকুলেট করো
ওকে করছি
See whether it is coming out 7.15 MSA or not.
No, I'm going to calculate.
কিন্তু একেবারে তো হবে এই ফর্মুলা লিখে দিয়েছি দেখো
ওটা ম্যাম 36 365 না 36.5
365 নাম্বার অফ ইয়ার্স এক ইয়ারে কত দিন হয় সিভিপিডি ছিল তো পার ডে ছিল ওটাকে এক বছরে কত হবে তাই মাল্টিপ্লাই করেছি 365 দেখো আর 7.5% আছে তাকে কনভার্ট করতে হবে মানে ডেসিমালে ডি ছিল তোমার কি বলছে টু লেন সিঙ্গেল ক্যারেজ ওয়ে ডি উইল বি 0.75 অর 75% সো অ্যাজ ইউ মে 5 অর 75 ডিভাইড বাই 100
এনটা কত হবে ম্যাডাম
নাম্বার অফ ইয়ার্স
15 15
ন্যাশনাল হাইওয়ে কি হচ্ছে না? মাল্টিপ্লাই দ্যাট উইথ 10 টু দি মাইনাস 6 টু গেট করেসপন্ডিং মিলিয়ন স্ট্যান্ডার্ড এক্সেল
365 1 + r কত নিয়েছো 0.075 15 1 এটা ব্র্যাকেট ক্লোজ ঠিক আছে এর ভ্যালু যেটা আছে d d কত নিয়েছো
ডিভাইড বাই আর করেছো নিচে আবার কি আসছে কত আসছে বড়টা আসছে কত এসেছে যে
ম্যাম এসে গেছে ঠিকঠাকই এসে গেছে
আচ্ছা
ম্যাম 9 আছে তো ম্যাম 9
বাকিদের কি এসেছে এটা দেখো
8.9
কি করে তুমি কি বসেছো এটা এটা আগে ক্যালকুলেট করতে হয় পিটা দিয়েছে মানে বিফোর কনস্ট্রাকশনে ভ্যালু দিয়েছে তো সেটা
বলছো ম্যাম আমার 7.149 এসেছে
হ্যাঁ সেটাই তো আসবে না ওর বলছে 8.9 সেটা আমি বলছি সুদীপ তা আছো নাকি চলে গেল আর ইকুয়ালস টু হচ্ছে তোমার 0.075 আমি এজিউম করতে বলেছি নাম্বার অফ কনস্ট্রাকশন পিরিয়ড হচ্ছে 3 ইয়ার্স
হ্যাঁ
তো বসাও 400 আসবে সেটাই এখানে বসবে ঠিক আছে এবার দেখো 2 লেন সিঙ্গল ক্যারেজ ওয়ে জন বলি আমি 75% হচ্ছে লেন ডিস্ট্রিবিউশন তো তার হচ্ছে 0.75 এখানে বসবে এফ অলরেডি গিভেন 2.5 এখানে বসো এলএসএফ নট গিভেন সো অ্যাজুম ইট অ্যাজ 1 আর আর হচ্ছে 7.5% ইফ নট গিভেন অ্যাজুম ইট অ্যাজ 7.5% গ্রোথ রেট ওকে দ্যাট ইজ 0.075 আর এন হচ্ছে তোমার নাম্বার অফ ইয়ার্স ডিজাইন পিরিয়ড ফর ন্যাশনাল হাইওয়ে বা স্টেট হাইওয়ে এর জন্য বলেছি 15 ইয়ার্স বসবে এখানে ডিভাইড বাই আর এগান
0.075
হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে এবার সেটা ইনটু 10 টু পাওয়ার মাইনাস 6 করলে মিলিয়ন স্ট্যান্ডার্ড এক্সেল হয় এবার সাগনিকে এসেছো তো নাকি চলে গেছে সাগনিক বাবারে আচ্ছা দেখো এন ভ্যালু ইট কেম আউট টু বি 7.15 MSA সিবিআর ইট ইজ গিভেন অ্যাজ আই অলরেডি সেড ফর টোটাল থিকনেস উই ক্যান ইউজ দিস চার্ট ইট লাইজ বিটুইন 1 টু 10 MSA সি এন হচ্ছে 1 টু 10 সো উই ক্যান ইউজ দিস চার্ট রাইট তো এখান থেকে আমরা পাচ্ছি 7 সো ইট উইল বি সামওয়্যার হিয়ার তো এটাকে ড্র করো ওটা 1 এর অন একটু এখানে থাকবে ঠিক আছে আর সিবিআর হচ্ছে তোমার জুম তো করা যাবে কিন্তু আমার স্ট্রেট লাইনটাই হবে না দেখো এটা দেখতে পাচ্ছ হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ
তোমার 7.1 ঠিক আছে সো ইট উইল বি সামওয়্যার হিয়ার ড্র দ্য স্ট্রেট লাইন পারপেন্ডিকুলার লাইন ড্র করো টাচ করবে কোথায় সিবিআর ইকুয়ালস টু 4 সো দিস কার্ভ ওকে নাও ফাইন্ড দ্য করেসপন্ডিং তোমার এই ভ্যালুটা ফাইন্ড করো ঠিক আছে করেসপন্ডিং থিকনেস ইজ গিভেন ফ্রম দিস অ্যাক্সিস তো আমি বলছি সাপোজ 650 এটা আমি ভালো হয়নি যাই হোক দেখে এখন এটা যা দেখে মনে হয় যে 650 mm এর কাছাকাছি ঠিক আছে সো দিস ভ্যালু ইজ অনলি দ্য টোটাল থিকনেস ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল লেয়ারের থিকনেস না টোটাল থিকনেস মানে পেভমেন্ট সাবগ্রেডের টপ অফ দি টোটাল থিকনেস, আর এদের মাঝখানে অনেক কটা লেয়ার্স থাকবে, রাইট? সো উই হ্যাভ টু ডিটারমাইন ইচ লেয়ার থিকনেস অলসো
ফর দ্যাট ইন্টারপোলেশন করব।
এখানে তো ইন্টারপোলেশনের ব্যাপারই না, এখানে তো তুমি দেখতে পাবে, ঠিক আছে? এখান থেকে শুধু আমি টোটাল থিকনেসটা পাবো, পেমেন্টের টোটাল থিকনেস, কিন্তু অনেক কটা প্রবলেমে তুমি এরকম না দিয়ে এরকম চার দেবে, ঠিক আছে? আমার দেখো কি ভ্যালু এসেছে, আওয়ার ভ্যালু কেম আউট টু বি 7.15 এম এস এ অ্যান্ড সিবিআর ইজ 4। চলো আমাদের আইআরসি কোডে যাই, আইআরসি কোডে দেখো অনেক কটা চার্ট আছে, কোন চার্টটা ইউজ করবো। 1 to 10 দেখতে হবে, 1 to 10 সবই 1 to 10 আছে, কিন্তু আমার সিবিআর ভ্যালুটা আলাদা আছে। যেমন ফার্স্টে আছে 2, তারপর আছে 3, তারপর 4। আমাদের সিবিআর কত ছিল? 4। সো আমি এই ক্যাটালগটা ইউজ করব। ওকে, এবার দেখো এই ক্যাটালগটা দেখে দেখো আমার ভ্যালু এসেছে কত, ইট কেম আউট টু বি 7.15, মানে এদের মাঝখানে হবে, রাইট? 5 আর 10 এর মাঝখানে হবে, 7.15, ঠিক আছে? তো এটা 5 এর জন্য টোটাল থিকনেস হচ্ছে দেখো 620, 10 এর জন্য 700, তাহলে 7.15 এর জন্য এদের মাঝখানে কিছু একটা থাকবে, রাইট? সো উই হ্যাভ টু ডিটারমাইন দ্যাট ভ্যালিউ বাই ইন্টারপোলেশন। সিমিলার ওয়ে এটা হচ্ছে টোটাল থিকনেসের কলম, আমি এখান থেকে টোটাল থিকনেস পাবো, এখান থেকে এই হচ্ছে ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল লেয়ারের থিকনেস, ওয়েয়ারিং কোর্স, বাইন্ডার কোর্স, গ্রানুলার কোর্স, বেস কোর্স, সাব বেস কোর্স। সাপোজ 5 to 10 এর, 5 এর জন্য হচ্ছে ওয়েয়ারিং কোর্স হচ্ছে 25 mm, 10 এর জন্য হবে 40 mm, তো অবভিয়াসলি 7.15 এর জন্য ইট উইল বি সামওয়ার বিটুইন দিস 25 and 40, অ্যান্ড উই হ্যাভ টু ক্যালকুলেট ইট বাই ইন্টারপোলেশন। সো সিমিলারলি ফর অল দ্য লেয়ার্স অ্যান্ড ডিটারমাইন দ্য করেসপন্ডিং ভ্যালুজ অফ ইচ লেয়ার করেসপন্ডিং টু দ্য MSA of 7.15, ঠিক আছে? ফর দিস এক্সাম্পল, আমাদের এই এক্সাম্পলের জন্য আমার MSA এসেছে 7.15 আর CBR 4, সো উই আর ইউজিং দ্যাট চার্ট, আমি এখানে বসিয়ে দিয়েছি, ঠিক আছে? দেখো 1 to 10 MSA, 7 যেটা আছে আর CBR হচ্ছে 4, তার মানে এদের মাঝখানে লাই করবে। সো আমি শুধু 5 আর 10 এর ভ্যালুটা নিয়ে রাখলাম, ঠিক আছে? এইগুলো আমি চার্ট থেকে পেয়ে গেলাম, এটা 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 আমি চার্ট থেকে পেয়ে গেছি, পাচ্ছি না তো কোনটা, এই ভ্যালুর জন্য করেসপন্ডিং থিকনেসগুলো, ঠিক আছে? মানে এটা এটা আমি ইন্টারপোলেট করে পেলাম। তাহলে ফর দিস ট্রাফিক ভ্যালু অ্যান্ড সিবিআর ইকোয়ালস টু 4, দ্য ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল লেয়ার থিকনেস আর 9 ফর ওয়েয়ারিং কোর্স, 61.72 for binder course, for granular base is 250 and for granular sub base it is 288, whereas the total thickness will be this much. Clear?
Yes ma'am.
Bujha gelo? So like this we can determine the thickness as per our IRC code keno bolchi ba modified CBR, okay, keno bolchi because all these are provided in your IRC 37 code as per the equation, এই যে n এর ভ্যালু যেটা করছি সেটা আমরা কোড থেকে পাচ্ছি। সো দিস ইজ দ্য টোটাল কনসেপ্ট, ক্লিয়ার? যদি আমি কোনো কোয়েশ্চেন দিই এখান থেকে, কোয়েশ্চেন তোমাদের আসতে পারে হচ্ছে VDF ক্যালকুলেশন অর ক্যাপিটাল N এর ক্যালকুলেশন, ঠিক আছে? অর থিকনেসের ক্যালকুলেশনও আসে, যদি এটা তোমাদের ম্যাকআউটের যেরকম আগে হতো, ঠিক আছে? ফর এমসিকিউ পারপোজ ক্যাপিটাল এন, ভিডিএফ, এগুলো হচ্ছে ইম্পর্ট্যান্ট। আর ফর 15 মার্কস গুলো যেগুলো হতো তার মধ্যে এটা পড়তো, মানে টোটাল থিকনেসটা বার করার আর ইন্ডিভিজুয়াল লেয়ারের থিকনেস ইউজিং আইআরসি কোড। ক্লিয়ার?
ইয়েস ম্যাম।
একটু গো থ্রু করো, এটা দিয়ে একটু, আমি অলরেডি পোস্ট করে দিয়েছি এটা থিওরি হ্যান্ড রিটেন নোটস, সেটা দেখো। আর তোমাদের জন্য একটু টাইমটা আমি দিচ্ছি, বেশি দিচ্ছি, ঠিক আছে? আমি 7:30 থেকে এক্সামটা দেবো বলেছিলাম, বাকিদের জন্য তোমরা এখনই স্টার্ট করতে পারবে না, তো তোমরা টাইম নিয়ে একটু পরে স্টার্ট করতে পারো। একটা আমি এক্সাম নেব, এক্সাম মানে কুইজ।
এই টিফিন করে করছি,
ঠিক আছে? টিফিন করে করো, তোমাদের জন্য ছাড় আছে, ঠিক আছে?
ঠিক আছে,
ঠিক আছে, তাহলে রেখে দাও।
ওকে ম্যাম, থ্যাংক ইউ।
বুঝেছো তুমি স্টাগনেট?
হ্যাঁ ম্যাম বুঝেছি ম্যাম।
আনসার তো বলে না। ঠিক আছে যাও পড়ো, ওটা পেপারতে দেখো একটু পিডিএফটা।
আপনি ম্যাম এই নোটটা কি ক্লাসরুমে ছেড়ে দেবেন?
ছেড়ে দিয়েছি অলরেডি সকালে।
ওকে ওকে ম্যাম, ওকে ম্যাম, থ্যাংক ইউ।
ঠিক আছে। ঠিক আছে, লিভ করতে পারো।